Hello and welcome, I'm Ken Gowdy from Sax Comprehensive, and in this video I will attempt to explain how to interpret sheet music when playing swing at a slow tempo. When you play from a piece of sheet music, you would either see at the top of the page the word swing with the tempo, or you will see two eighth notes, an equal sign and a tied triplet. What these notation mean is that the music, which will be written down in a normal fashion, should not be played in a normal fashion, but rather interpreted and played with the swing feel instead. Basically what that means is that the eighth notes should not be played as even eighth notes, but as tied triplets. So a series of eighth notes like this, which would normally be played like this, now needs to be interpreted and played like this. If we compare the two ways of playing eighth notes, you will notice in the first way, the normal way of playing these notes, the notes are played even and either played on the on beat or on the off beat. The swing notes, by contrast, the longer note is played on the on beat or down beat, and the shorter note is played after the off beat or up beat. And both these notes, because they're played as tied triplets, the second note is shifted over. So the first thing that you need to do is to get used to the swing feel. You can do this by playing scales with a swing feel. If we interpret these notes as part of a tied triplet, then the first note will last 2/3 and the second note will last a third in duration. Or the first note will last twice as long as the second note. But realistically, musicians play swing with different ratios between playing like this and playing them even. If the tempo is fast, then these eighth notes will be played straight and even, since the tempo makes it difficult to maintain these ratios. When playing at faster tempos, the swing feel is achieved through various techniques such as accenting the peaks of the melody while possibly half-tonguing the troughs. The next important thing to remember is that it's not just a matter of playing the first eighth note long and the second eighth note short. It depends on where these notes fall. If the notes start on the on beat, then it's long. If the note is written on the off beat, then it is short. So a passage containing eighth notes that starts on the off beat will be started with a short note. But remember, since it is interpreted as tied triplets, this short note will be played after the off beat. All other notes apart from the eighth notes are played normally. So triplets are played with their normal value, as are longer notes. Other techniques used in articulation still apply, such as playing certain accented notes short, but the best way to become familiar with this is to listen to swing music. As I said before, different musicians will use different ratios instead of the 2/3, 1/3 ratio, so you should not get too hung up on making it precise. Rather than trying to count the triplets, try to develop a swing feel instead, and just make sure that one eighth note is longer than the other. Also, there should not be a gap between the notes, it should be a smooth legato feel. Lastly, tongue the off beats and slow them to the on beats with a smooth legato tonguing, such as when using the syllable da instead of ta. Now let's see this in practice by looking at a few passages of Lester Young's song, Love Me or Leave Me. Here, the first three notes are quarter notes, the first two of which are accented. Then the next few notes are eighth notes, so we have to start interpreting them as swing notes. The first eighth note is on the on beat, so we start playing them as long, short, etc. Let's look at this in triplet notation. So here are the swing notes written as played. Then we get to the tied eighth note. This is a bit tricky since it has to be played as a short eighth note, which is lengthened. So start it at the usual position as when playing the last note of a triplet, but lengthen it until you get to, as it were, the last note of the triplet on the next beat, and then repeat this for the next note. This would be easier to do with a backing track. Let's listen to the music again and the music played as a MIDI triplet notation. They sound virtually the same, apart from the inflections. The same principles apply to the next line. You just need to consider where the note starts when playing as tied triplets and maintain this when you come across tied notes. Remember, it should be smooth, so there should not be any gaps unless the music indicates this. This means that the length of certain notes will need to be interpreted when you come across tired or dotted notes. As you can see, writing music in the triplet notation makes it more complicated to read, but also musicians will not always play the music like this, but may delay the start of the note so that they do not start exactly on the beat, to give a different type of swing feel, such as a more laid-back feeling. Once you have listened to several swing music, you will get the hang of it, and you'll be able to interpret the sheet music in a way that feels right for you. Thank you.